Dear Aubrey, I'm taking your advice and heading out for parts unknown. But I need you to know how sorry I am for the impact I have had in your life. The fire that took the life of your mother was an accident, a horrible accident that was not supposed to happen. But it did. And I am to blame. I am not asking you to forgive me. I don't want you to forgive me. No, I don't want you to forgive me, Aubrey. I want you to hate me. Try to have ducks back and become a better person than I. With love, Edmund Kelly Chicane.
You slam into Danny, and it hurts. That hurts. And the two of you kind of spiral and crash to the ground, and Danny's on top of you, and she leans backward and starts to dive her jagged teeth down into your neck. And just at the last second, Barclay runs in and grabs her. And holds her under the arms. And from the ground where you're laying, you see him pulling her. She is restrained and fighting, but he is pulling her back toward Amnesty Lodge. And Mama looks at him and then looks down at you. And then you realize that everybody is looking down at you. And then you feel your back start to get wet. And then you don't feel anything on your back anymore, and then you start to feel cold. And from your position on the ground, your vision is starting to fade a bit, but you look up and you see the only rifle that is still pointed outward with some smoke coming out of it belongs to Pigeon, who looks terrified. She collapses. And you hear Mama talking, and she's saying something, and she's frantically gesturing to Sheriff Owens, who nods and takes off running for help. And then Mama asks you something, and you can't quite make it out, and then she shouts your name, and she shouts something else, but you just can't hear it anymore. You just hear the wind, and you just see the stars above you. They are beautiful. And then they're gone.